Why can't we divide by zero? This question follows us all the way from elementary school to calculus and beyond. Let's explore the answer to this question in five levels, ranging from an answer you can explain to a five-year-old through explanations that are usually only seen by math majors or graduate students. For the first level, let's focus on what division means in the first place. Imagine you have six cookies and you want to give them away to your two friends. You want both friends to get the same amount of cookies, so you give them three each. Six cookies divided by two friends equals three each. And if you had three friends, six cookies divided by three friends equals two cookies each. But how do you split six cookies evenly among zero friends? No matter how many cookies you give each person, there are still no people to receive any cookies. So six cookies divided by zero people is undefined. It just doesn't make any sense to ask that question. We can contrast this with a similar question. What if you had zero cookies and you want to split them up evenly among six friends? You have no cookies to give, so each friend gets zero, but this actually does make sense. Zero cookies divided by six people equals zero each. For level two, let's look at fractions. Imagine you have a pie. If you want to divide the pie into four equal pieces, we know how to do that. You end up with four pieces, each 1/4 of the whole pie. You could also divide it into three pieces or two pieces, and dividing by one still works. That's just one whole pie. But how do you divide a pie into zero pieces? If there aren't any pieces, there isn't any pie, but we're supposed to divide up one whole pie. Again, dividing by zero is undefined. For level three, let's look at an algebraic approach. Say we want to find 6 divided by 0. We can write x equals 6 divided by 0. Division is the inverse of multiplication, so this should be the same thing as asking for what value of x satisfies the equation 0 times x equals 6. What number, when we multiply it by 0, gives us 6? Well, there isn't one. Any number times zero is just zero. So there is no possible solution for x. Well, no real number anyway. For level four, let's look at calculus, where things get even more interesting. Although we can't divide six by zero, we can divide six by a small number close to zero, like 0.01. This gives us 600. This isn't exactly our original question, but it seems reasonable it should be close. We can divide by an even smaller number to get an even better estimate, say 6 divided by 0.001. This gives us 6,000. The smaller we make that denominator, the closer it is to zero, and the bigger the quotient will be. The quotient is approaching infinity. In calculus, we call this a limit. The limit of 6 over x as x approaches zero from the positive side is equal to infinity. If we graph the function y equals 6 over x, we can see this limit. There's a vertical asymptote at 0, and on the right side of it, the function goes to infinity. So what happens when we divide by a negative number that's very close to 0? On this side, the limit of 6 over x as x approaches 0 from the negative side is equal to negative infinity. So we still can't divide by 0, but this gives us a solution to a similar question. A positive number divided by an infinitesimal positive number is infinity. But keep in mind, this answer of infinity does not help us in all contexts. For example, it still doesn't really make sense to say that you could split up six cookies among zero friends by giving each friend infinitely many cookies. For level five, let's dive into the world of abstract algebra. This branch of math explores the abstract algebraic properties of certain objects. For example, we might wonder about the algebraic properties of the moves of a Rubik's Cube, or the hours on a clock. We can add two different hours, but the arithmetic works a little differently than usual. If you use 12-hour time, then what is 2 hours after 11 o'clock? This would be 1 o'clock, so we could say 11 plus 2 equals 1. Adding times in this way gives us an example of a group. A set of objects with a notion of addition which satisfies certain properties. One key property is the existence of an identity element. In the case of a 12-hour clock, adding or subtracting 12 hours does not change the time. For example, 12 hours after 3 o'clock is still 3 o'clock. So we say that 12 is the identity element, and often we would write it as 0. Another key property is that every value has an inverse. Say we add 11 plus 2 equals 1, and we want to undo that operation to get back to 11 o'clock. Well, we can add 10 more hours to do that. 1 plus 10 equals 11. So we say that 10 and 2 are additive inverses in this group. And we can use this to define subtraction. Subtracting 2 is the same as adding 10 in this group. So what if we want to have more structure? A field is a set where addition and multiplication can be performed, which satisfies certain properties. A field must have an additive identity that we call 0 and a multiplicative identity that we call 1. Adding 0 does not change a value, and multiplying by 1 does not change a value. So how do we define division? Just like in the group, we can use inverses. To divide by x, we can multiply by the multiplicative inverse of x. In a field, every element, except 0, must have a multiplicative inverse. The multiplicative inverse of x is the value y, where x times y equals 1. So why does 0 not have a multiplicative inverse? We would need to solve the equation 0 times y equals 1, but 0 times y is always 0. So 0 has no multiplicative inverse, and there is no way for us to define what it means to divide by 0 in the field. As we've seen, dividing by 0 comes up in many contexts along our math journeys. Do you have another way to think about dividing by 0? I would love to read about it in the comments. Thanks for watching, subscribe for more, and I'll see you next time.